away from watching the very first Formula E race on home soil in Hyderabad City, and here's all you need to know about it before the race weekend. No, Formula E is not an electric version of Formula One. Formula E is the electric future of car racing and is still at a relatively early stage in its ninth year. 11 teams with known names like Mahindra, Jaguar, McLaren, Maserati, Nissan and 22 world-class drivers, including many big names in the motorsport world, compete against each other on street circuits around the world. And this year, the fourth round of this World Championship is being held alongside the Hussain Sagar Lake in Hyderabad City, a city that's home to some of the biggest tech hubs of the country. While Formula E has been around for less than a decade, the novel and challenging idea of racing electric cars on popular street circuits around the world way back in 2014 caught the interest of early adopters like Mahindra Racing, Audi Sport ABT, Venturi Formula E and even Formula E Renault team backed by four-time Formula One world champion Alain Prost, to name a few. With each generation, the advancements in technologies used in powertrains and batteries have seen the Formula E cars leap in engine power, regenerative ability, range and speed. While limited battery range in Gen 1 cars meant every team had to equip their drivers with two race cars to make it to the checkered flag, Gen 2 cars allowed for more range and hence car swapping wasn't a requirement anymore. It's the Gen 2 era that saw a big bump in popularity of the sport, ushering in names like Mercedes EQ, BMW, Porsche, Audi, Jaguar and Nissan to the World Championship. With the ever-evolving techscape, the year 2023 has brought with it Gen 3 race cars that produce 350 kilowatt of power, capable of touching speeds of 320 kilometers per hour, and can regenerate power up to 600 kilowatt, which means 40% of the energy used during the course of the race comes from regenerative braking. Coming to the race format itself, unlike Formula One, where it's a three-day race weekend, in Formula E, it all happens in a span of 2 days. On Saturday, it's all on the clock. Group qualifying sessions for 24 minutes in total that ultimately leads to duels of the top four finishers in each group to decide the starting grid of the race. The race itself this year is being run on a fixed number of laps, which in case of the 2.83 km Hyderabad street circuit will be anywhere between 35 to 40 laps. While all teams will be racing cars with identical batteries provided by Williams Advanced Engineering, all-weather tyres from Hankook and chassis designed by Dallara, the teams get autonomy to develop their own powertrains with their own choice of electric motor and even gearbox. During the race, the drivers are allowed to activate attack mode just twice strategically that enables them to use 50 kilowatt of additional power to gain an advantage during crucial battles. For F1 fans, it's something similar to DRS in Formula One, but not quite. Now coming to who you'd want to keep an eye out for. Home favourites, Mahindra Racing, have been veterans in this sport, being one of the very first teams to sign up to this championship way back in 2014. Till date, the team has claimed 10 pole positions, 24 podiums and 5 race wins. After their toughest season so far in 2022, the team has renewed championship hopes for this year with Brazilian Formula E champion Lucas Di Grassi taking to the wheels, who kept adrift our high expectations with a podium finish in the first Formula E race of this season. Of course, the bigger connect this year is our very own Jehan Daruwala, who will be assisting the Mahindra Racing team as reserve driver. Up next, we have the Jaguar TCS Racing team, who in a span of 80 races have claimed 4 pole positions, 12 podium finishes and 8 wins. With Season 8 Formula E runner-up Mitch Evans and an experienced hand in Sam Bird, the Jaguar TCS Racing team are keeping their eyes on both the drivers and team championship world title this year. The Porsche team heads to Hyderabad as championship leaders, having aced all three races till date, and you've also got big names like Maserati making a comeback to motor racing after a long hiatus of over 6 decades, McLaren is celebrating the iconic brand's 60th year by racing in Formula E, and you might also want to keep an eye out for ABT Sportsline running Mahindra powertrains, becoming the Indian squad's first customer racing team in the championship this year. Given it's a street circuit, spectators will get a chance to see all the racing action at close quarters. So you can head online to book your tickets now and hurry, because the tickets have been on sale since early January. We'll certainly get you all the buzz from Hyderabad. Until then, stay charged.